Hello guys, welcome to our channel Speaking Books. We will be continuing the discussion of the book Think and Grow Rich. In this chapter, we will discuss an extremely important factor that will determine your success and riches in life. Persistence, the sustained effort necessary to induce faith, the eighth step toward riches. Persistence is an essential factor in the procedure of transmuting desire into its monetary equivalent. The basis of persistence is the power of will. Willpower and desire, when properly combined, make an irresistible pair. Men who accumulate great fortunes are generally known as cold-blooded and sometimes ruthless. Often they are misunderstood. What they have is willpower, which they mix with persistence and place back of their desire to ensure the attainment of their objectives. Henry Ford has been generally misunderstood to be ruthless and cold-blooded. This misconception grew out of Ford's habit of following through in all of his plans with persistence. If you are following this book with the intention of applying the knowledge it conveys, your first test as to your persistence will come when you begin to follow the six steps described in the second chapter. Unless you are one of the two out of every 100 who already have a definite goal at which you are aiming and a definite plan for its attainment, you may read the instructions and then pass on with your daily routine and never comply with those instructions. He says that Thomas Edison failed more than 10,000 times in his attempts, but Edison continues to persist and work on his experiment despite all the failures. Most people will quit after failing a few times, let alone 10,000 times like Edison. And this is exactly why most people fail to amass wealth or success in life. They simply jump to conclusion that things will not work out and they give up way too soon. Remember the story of Derby? He was just 3 feet away from striking gold, but he quit way too soon. Persistence is a state of mind, therefore it can be cultivated. Like all states of mind, persistence is based upon definite causes. Following are among them. First, definiteness of purpose. Knowing what one wants is the first and the most important step toward the development of persistence. Second, desire. It is comparatively easy to acquire and to maintain persistence in pursuing the object of intense desire. Third, self-reliance. Believe in one's ability to carry out a plan encourages one to follow the plan through the persistence. Fourth, definiteness of plans. Organized plans encourage persistence. Fifth, accurate knowledge. Knowing that one's plan, based upon experience, encourages persistence. Sixth, cooperation. Sympathy, understanding, and harmonious cooperation with others tend to develop persistence. Seventh, willpower. The habit of concentrating one's thoughts upon the building of plans for the attainment of a definite purpose leads to persistence. And the last one, habit. Persistence is the direct result of habit. The mind absorbs and becomes a part of the daily experiences upon which it feeds. As one makes an impartial study of prophets, philosophers, miracle men, and religious leaders of the past, one is drawn to the inevitable conclusion that persistence, concentration of effort, and definiteness of purpose were the major sources of their achievements. Ending this chapter with a wonderful quote by our author, "The habit of persistence is the best insurance against failure." Thank you all. Make sure you like, subscribe and share. Please share your feedback in the comment section. Goodbye. Have a great day.